So now to come to the formal part of the evening, I would like to introduce to you our master of ceremonies this evening, Mr. Edward Williams. Hooray! I would like to know if anybody is here who has never attended one of these events before. Can you raise your hand, please? Okay. The young lady with the flowers. You will be carrying the neck. Oh, it's Anya. Right, okay. You'll be carrying the neck.
I'm not a she, but I have just two hands.
That's okay. Somebody else will carry your flowers.
Thank you very much.
If you come up with any for this bit here.
Yeah. And according to our tradition, you have to spend the night with the man with the sign.
Yeah.
I'd like now to hand over to Eddie, who will start the beginning of this evening's proceedings.
I am. I am.
What are you?
Andrew Guinness. Penyar. Well, that was painless, wasn't it?
Keep going this way. Dr. Roscoe.
Right, Tamina here has been recently. We've been looking at a thing called Guldize pudding and various other harvest sweets and cakes and stuff that were traditional in Penzance. And Tamina has found these, which is Penzance cake, which is something that was traditionally eaten at harvest time.
It's based on a recipe from 1728. A disgraced Cambridge professor was sacked from his job, and he went around the country instead collecting recipes, and Penzance cake was one of them. So it's like a yeast cake. It's got mulled fruit, dried fruit, got wine in it, spices, sugar, and it's made with Zenna flour from Truy Mill. So it's quite dense, it's quite spicy and fruity, it's got lots of ginger and peel in it. So if you're gluten-free or dairy-free, don't go near them. They've got no nuts in them.
Good that they're in the
they're
room.
All in the
yeah.
What did the professor do? What did the professor do to disgrace himself? Question!
Yes.
What did the most important part of that story is? What did the professor do to disgrace himself?
That I haven't found out yet.
Oh,
he put something in the cake.
Exactly. I'll come round.